Blessings to everyone in the name of Jesus. I'm happy to be with you today this time. So today God is going to speak into your life, into your family, into your ministry. God has given a message to me to share with you. That is about the message is the message about the cross. Hallelujah. So I welcome all brothers and sisters who are watching this video. Welcome, Brother Richards. Thank you for watching this video. Welcome all brothers and sisters. Welcome Sister Joyce Shaltan. Hallelujah. God is going to extend your boundaries, Sister Joyce Shaltan. And Sister Remya Rai, the grace of the Lord is upon you. Sister Daira Eva, I see a financial breakthrough. And Brother Richards, many international connections are coming to you. So the grace of the Lord be upon everyone, those who are watching. So God is making a move in this time. God is looking for faithful servants who are in the ministry, who are faithful to the Lord at this time, because it is lockdown, the pandemic is spreading everywhere, the COVID-19 is spreading everywhere, so people are confused, but God is looking into the hearts of people who are those faithful to God. So I welcome Sister Carol Smith, Sister Norma Gasa, all brothers and sisters. God is going to bless each and everyone. Sister Clary Offrey, I see an increase in the anointing. You are going to stand in the pulpit. I see that. You are going to stand in the pulpit. The grace of the Lord is upon everyone. So, before coming into the video, let us close our eyes to pray for a moment. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you, Lord, for your presence being released here. Let your grace be upon everyone, those who are watching this video. Let the grace be upon this platform. I pray in the name of Jesus. I intercede for everyone, those who are watching. Let your hand touch everyone, bless everyone in the name of Jesus. Let there be clarity in every sense. Give me accuracy in revelation, prophecy. May the power and fire of God be released and people be anointed, filled with the Holy Spirit, healed and delivered. And let everyone be moved to the next level. And only the name of Jesus be exalted. Thank you, Lord, for all your grace. In the name of Jesus, amen. So I welcome everyone. Today I have a message to share with you. It is from the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 18. I will read that. Hallelujah. Today morning I asked the Lord, Lord, you have not given me a message till this time. So I asked for a message. Lord, show me a cross. He showed me a cross. That's why I am reading this message. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It is from the 1 Corinthians chapter 1, 18th verse. For the message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. So, the verse is saying, the message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. Hallelujah. The verse is saying that it is the message of cross is foolishness to those who are determined to be perished. But for us, because we are being saved, it is not foolishness. It is the power of God. How many of you have the experience of the cross? Somebody is asking, what is the message of the cross? What is the experience of the cross? Not just reading the message and preaching. It is not the message of the cross. But if you have an experience, if you have an experience of the cross in your life, that will be an added advantage, not an added advantage. It is the fully grace of the Lord. It is good to study in the Bible college. It is good to read Bible again and again. But I tell you, if you have the message of the cross, that message of the cross will bring you anointing. That message of the cross will raise you to the next level. Hallelujah. Somebody is asking, what is this message of cross? You know, Jesus was crucified and he was resurrected on the third day for us. He carried all our sins. He carried all our temptation. He carried all our curses, all our family curses that was in our family from generation to generation. He carried all the stagnant, all the delay. He carried all the emptiness. He carried all the curses, all the diseases, all the spreading diseases, all the COVID-19. He carried on the cross. How many of you believe? So he carried everything, all your miseries, all your sorrows on the cross. And that is the message of the cross. So Galatians 3:13 says that Jesus has purchased us. He has brought us for a price. And what is that price? That is the repentance. When you repent, when you accept that Jesus has taken all the curses, then you will be saved, and not only that, you will be blessed. You will have the experience of the cross. Oh, Shakaram Darava. God is going to bless everyone, those who are watching this video. So I see a financial breakthrough also. That is the anointing of the financial breakthrough is overflowing. I see that the wounds in your heart, Sister Sinimaria, the wounds in your heart are healed. I hear the word healing. The hand of Jesus is coming upon you, more grace. Hallelujah. So message of the cross, it is going to give you a change. Somebody is saying that I have very good experience in the university degrees. I have acquired many degrees, but no, I am not telling about this kind of wisdom. That is the worldly wisdom. Maybe you have studied in good universities. That is good. That is good. Education is good, but I am not telling about that education. I am speaking about the wisdom of God. I will read that the next verse. It says, hallelujah. Hallelujah. The 21th verse, it says, for since in the wisdom of God, the world through wisdom did not know God. Hallelujah. So in the 19th verse, it says, 1 Corinthians 1:19, it is saying, I will destroy. The Lord is saying, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise and bring to nothing the understanding of the prudent. So I am not preaching about the wisdom of the knowledge of the world, but I am preaching about the message of the cross. How many of you have the message of the cross? Hallelujah. Somebody is asking, what is the message? When your in-laws ill-treat you, when you be silent, that is the, you will have the message of the cross. When your neighbors mock at you, when your friends tease at you, when you are silent and accept that circumstance in the name of Jesus, you have the message of the cross. Maybe you are passing through many tribulations. Maybe you are having many pain in your body, in your heart. Maybe you are having many diseases. Maybe you are having through many tribulations. You are passing through many hurdles, many difficulties. But every person will have such kind of disease, such kind of pain. But if you accept that all these tribulations you are now passing through, you are facing, is just carrying the cross. What Jesus said, if you carry your cross and follow me, you will be my disciple. Hallelujah. This is what the teaching of Jesus, carrying the cross, whatever problems you have. Maybe you are rejected in your house. The people have said that you are good for nothing. Your own people have said that you are a waste, you are a good for nothing. But I tell you, if you be silent and if you do not murmur, understand one thing, that you are carrying the cross. You are carrying your own cross. And that is the, you have the message of the cross. Hallelujah. So that's why Paul said in the book of Colossians 1:24, we can see that he is rejoicing in his cross. He is rejoicing for all the pain he is carrying in his body, because he is carrying all the cross that what Jesus has left on the cross. So today I tell you that if you have the experience of the cross, God is going to raise you into the next level. So when you have the experience of the cross, you must get delighted. You must be delighted. When you are in need, you must delight. Because Paul has said that he has the experience how to be in plenty, how to be in need. He has the experience how to be when he is rejected. So he has passed through many, many areas of many difficulties of his life. So he has that experience. So when you are in need, be happy. When you are tempted, praise God. Praise God. And God will lift you up. Because when you have a tribulation, you must understand that you are carrying the cross of Jesus. Hallelujah. You are having the cross of Jesus. So whatever problems you face right now, that is God is going to use you for a mighty ministry, for a mighty miracles. Hallelujah. How many of you understand? So If you are doing the ministry, understand one thing: the qualification what you want in the ministry to be successful is you should have the experience of the cross. Hallelujah! You should have the experience of the cross. I heard one young man saying that he is waiting. He is waiting for some money to start the ministry. But this is not a business, waiting for the money to start. Because if you have the experience of the cross, you can do the ministry. Hallelujah. God told Abraham, come out from your place. From that moment his ministry started. How many of you believe? Abraham was a man praying in his house. He was praying in his house. In his house there were his parents, relatives, everyone. So when God told Abraham, you come out from your place, immediately he came out without asking, where I will go, Lord, how I will have the provision. He did not ask God. So at the moment he left his house, his ministry was started. How many of you believe? So somebody is waiting for the fund to come. Somebody is waiting for the money to come for the ministry. This is not a business. If you have the message of cross, if you have the message of cross, you will have the anointing. You do not wait for somebody. You do not expect anything from somebody, because if you have the message of cross, the anointing will bring everything. The provision came to Elijah because he had the anointing. The provision came through ravens because he had the experience of the cross. How many of you believe? So God is going to bless everyone. Hallelujah. I see an increase in knowledge. An increase in knowledge. Hallelujah. More deep. Sister Carol Smith, I see an increase in knowledge. God is giving you more knowledge. More. You have been passing through many deep wounds, but God is healing you. God is touching you. God is blessing your family. The grace of the Lord is upon you. Hallelujah. So, hallelujah. Here the Bible says, the message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing. In my early days, when I used to minister, when I used to preach about Jesus, people used to yarn. People used to get, I feel that they used to get bored. So I asked a senior servant of God, why these people are getting bored when I preach about Jesus? Then he said from his experience, if you tell about the worldly things, if you tell about cricket, if you tell about the movies, if you tell about the politics, if you tell about the worldly things, all the sports, athletics, all the great inventions, everything what you tell, they will be happy. When you say about a movie, about a hero, they will be happy. They won't get bored. If you tell about God, for some time they will listen, for some time, after that they will get bored. But if you tell about Jesus, immediately they began to sleep. Their eyes began to close. They will feel sleepy. They get bored. They will begin to yawn. Why? That senior minister told me, it is because the message of Jesus, the message of cross as the anointing. So the devil doesn't like to have the anointing on that person. So the devil makes them sleepy. That's why they are yawning. That's why they are feeling sleepy. How many of you? So the message of the cross is foolishness to those people who are determined to be perished. Those who are perishing, it is foolishness. So it will be boring. But to those who have decided to serve the Lord, to those who have decided to have the eternal blessing, to those, it is an anointing. It is the power of God. So if you have the experience of the cross, that experience will raise you to the next level. Somebody is telling you, oh, you have nothing. What do you have? Somebody is looking at you and some of your close persons are looking at you and telling, what you have? You are nothing. You are not a valuable person. You have no money. You have no wealth. You have no education. You don't look good. You are not good looking. You have nothing. You have no house. You have no, you are walking. You have no house. You have no vehicle. You have no money balance. Hallelujah. Don't get disappointed. Hallelujah. The Israelites, they walked for many years. They walked for many years, but only few of them carried the cross of Jesus. Others murmured, others were disappointed. They could not enter the promised land. Those who were in the wilderness struggling, they were murmuring, they were rejecting everything, the promise of the God. They murmured against the leader Moses and murmured against God who called them from Egypt. So they lost their promises. So they were struggling. So, but a few, Caleb, Joshua, their generation, they did not murmur because they accepted this as the cross of Jesus. Hallelujah. They accepted this as the cross of Jesus, and only the generation were alive to see the promised land. I tell you that if you have the message, if you have the experience of the cross, you won't be rejected. Maybe your neighbors, your friends will reject you. But the time is coming that the anointing will bring you honor. The anointing will bring you grace. There was a man in the Bible, in the book of Matthew, in the Gospel, Luke, John, we can see that. A man was forced to carry the cross of Jesus. His name was Simon. He was forced to carry the cross of Jesus. So with much hesitation, he carried the cross of Jesus. But the history says that man's children were honored. One became a bishop, one became the governor. So God blessed that family. If you accept the cross that you are carrying this cross for the sake of Jesus, you will have the anointing, you will be blessing. How many of you know? Because the time is coming now. How many of you know? If you have the cross, if you have a pain, if you have an injury, if you have a pain in your body, if you have a pain in your heart, in your mind, if you are in need of something, maybe in finance or some other utensils, if you are in lacking reputation, if you are rejected, understand one thing, you have to accept what you are passing through for the sake of Jesus. That is the experience. So delight for what you do not have. What you do not have, don't cry to God. Lord, did John the apostle cry when he was sent to Patmos? Did John the apostle cry, Lord, take me out of this Patmos island. I cannot stay here. Please, I want to do the ministry. I want to do the. He did not cry like that because he had the revelation that God wanted to do something that will make a history. How many of you? So why you are passing through this tribulation? God wants to make you a history. You are. It is almost reached. The anointing is going to release. It is now coming. It is going to finish. That's why we see the COVID-19 everywhere. People wearing masks because a great revival is going to take place. And you are a part of that revival. And what you have the experience, it is not any other wisdom of this world, but you have the experience of the cross. So do not murmur. Be silent. Be silent like John the apostle. And be silent. Don't murmur. Carry the cross and delight. What? Maybe you are alone in your room. Things are not moving according to your plan. Maybe in your mind you have many projects. You want to come in the television. You want to minister in the stadium, big stadium. You want a big millions of people, many desires. You want to fly from one nation to another nation. Many desires you have. You want a big house. You want a good car to travel. You want much money for the ministry, everything. So you are in need. But these plans are not working. It is not working. But don't murmur. Just be silent and say thank to God, because when whatever situation you are passing through, accept that in the name of Jesus, and that is you are carrying the cross for Jesus. You are carrying your cross for Jesus, for the sake of Jesus. And what you will get, you might ask, hallelujah, you might ask what you will get, but you expect Jesus. You expect the love of God. Mark 10:28. Peter is asking Jesus, we have left everything. You know, Peter was a fisherman. Other disciples were tax collectors. So they left everything. They left everything for the sake of Jesus. And Peter is asking Jesus, Jesus, we have left everything. We have left our family. We have left everything for the sake of you. What we will get? Hallelujah. You know, Mark 10:28-30, Jesus is saying, those, assuredly I say you, those who have left wife, children, those who have left lands, houses, those who have left everything for the sake of me and for the gospel, you will get a hundredfold in this world. Assuredly, I say you. How many of you understand? Hallelujah. So, it is very nearby. Why you are watching this video? Because you are in the list of God. So it is the power of God. But those who are perishing, they don't listen. They don't listen because they are the perishing people. So it is foolishness. The message of the cross is foolishness to them. But those who are watching this video, it is not foolishness to you. That's why God brought you before this video. Because God has a plan in your life. And it is going to see. You are going to see. What God has kept for you for a long time, you are going to see after this lockdown. How many of you understand? After this lockdown, your life is going to change. I prophesy in the name of Jesus that after this lockdown, your lifestyle is going to change because you are carrying the cross for a long time. How many of you? Do not murmur, be silent and be thankful to God. Praise God. Because the anointing is upon you. that those who are carrying the cross, the anointing is upon you. Hallelujah. So I am going to pray for you. Shakarindoruba. How many of you have the experience of the cross? A great change that even you have never imagined, even you have never imagined, something great is going to happen in your life. Everyone will be wondered how, when Jesus was doing miracles, everyone, all the Jews, everyone in the church asked, who is this person doing the miracle? Is he the son of the carpenter? Hallelujah. Likewise, people will ask you, how many of you believe and say an amen? People will ask, they will talk to each other, who this person is, from where this person got all this knowledge. Then you should not become arrogant, you should not become proud of yourself, but the time is coming that God is going to lift you and people will ask you, from where you got all this wisdom? Have you studied in any big universities? Then you must humbly say that this is not the wisdom from which I acquired from any university or from any Bible college or from my parents, but this is the wisdom that I got the revelation when I carried the cross. When I carried the cross, I did not murmur. I was silent. So God was giving me revelations. God was giving me revelation. God was giving me knowledge when I was carrying the cross. So I was silent. So do not murmur. When Abraham came out of his house, actually he had nothing. He was born in a rich family. So God told him, leave everything, come out. So at the moment his ministry began to start. His great ministry, that the father to the nations. He is the father. Abraham is the father to the nations. That was an anointing upon him. So it was a fatherly anointing. And because all the blessings that now we are enjoying are coming through Abraham in the name of Jesus. So that his ministry started when he left everything. So he had no knowledge where to go, what to do, because he wanted to look up. When he was in his house, he had provision. But when he was on the way, he had to look up for the grace. There are enemies on the way. He was in need. When Sarah was dying, he wanted a place to bury. So everything God provided. Hallelujah. How many of you understand? So when the time comes for God to bless you and anoint you, it will be a deliverance. It will be a great deliverance. I am not telling any lies or joking. Those who are carrying the cross. Hallelujah. That is the message of the cross. Is the power of God. It is the power of God. When you are silent in your wilderness. When you accept your wilderness as carrying the cross for the sake of Jesus. Understand one thing, that God is noting everything in the diary, in his diary. You know, when you read the book of Nehemiah, when you read the book of Leviticus, the Numbers, we can see what all the children of Israel has did. Even fixing a window, a door, everything there, it is written. Even the hinges, those who have screwed the hinges, those who have fixed the door, those who have plastered the wall, everything is written in the book of Nehemiah, in the book of Leviticus, Numbers. Why? Because those who have fixed, they have forgotten, but God doesn't forget. He will keep, he will write in his diary. So when you pass through tribulation, when you pass through many negative situations, understand one thing, then God is writing everything in his diary. So a time is coming that God is going to honor you. God is going to making you prosperous. God is going to bless you. Hallelujah. So it is coming. How many of you experience? So I am going to pray for everyone. Hallelujah. Shakaram Taraba. Let the grace of the Lord be upon everyone. Hallelujah. Let the healing power be released in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So, if you have the experience of the cross, hallelujah. If you have the experience of the cross, you expect a great miracle in these days. God is watching you. God is watching you. Your name, whatever you are doing, what all things you are doing at this time, God is looking and watching you, and a promotion is coming ahead. Hallelujah. Sister Janine Delong. Hallelujah. So you have been, the Lord is saying that you have been carrying the cross for a long time. So in this time, in this season, it is going to become an end to what you face. What you are facing, it is coming to end. Because God is going to bless you. And because of your blessing, your children are blessed. Your family is blessed. Hallelujah. You are going to become fruitful. I see the gift, many gifts coming to you. Hallelujah. It is coming in a package. You can experience. Hallelujah. Shaka rim turum. It is opening. Rebecca Kasi, sister, it is opening. The ways are opening. Hallelujah. The system is changing. The Rebecca Kasi, sister, the Lord is saying the system is changing. That means the means are changing and you are going in a new way, in a new direction. That is what the system is changing. Lena Grava, sister, increase in knowledge. Hallelujah. Norma Grasa, sister, it is coming in your name. The property is coming in your name. Hallelujah. The evangelist J. Chavas, I see the multicolor anointing upon you. The grace of the Lord is upon you. It is the multicolor anointing. O Shaka Ramdharama. Let Holy Spirit minister. Hallelujah. Let you open your mind, open your heart so as to receive a word. Let Holy Spirit connect. Hallelujah. Let Holy Spirit connect to you. The grace of the Lord is upon this altar. Hallelujah. An extension in the boundary. Hallelujah. Myra Muni, sister, an extension in the boundaries. Hallelujah. It is coming frequently. It is Shondi Anderson, sister. The tribulations, the problems in your house, you are facing in intervals. But today I see the curses have been taken away. God is erasing everything and making your life into the next level. You won't see any curses. There are many curses that has been coming from your ancestors. Some of you are not well, some of you are misled, some of you have done the business and lost everything. But today the Lord is saying everything is coming to an end. Your family is going to be blessed. Hallelujah. Because you have not denied anything. You have accepted your cross. So the Lord's grace is upon you. Shalemi Ruki Naba. Hallelujah. So the Lord is taking your problems, Sister Jelisa Wolford. I see that you have many burdens. I see you are carrying many burdens on your shoulder. That it is very difficult. Many problems you are facing. But I see the Lord telling you, accept what all burdens you have for the sake of Jesus, and God will bless you. And in these days, I see that God is giving you more wisdom, more knowledge. The anointing is going to increase in you. Shakilim Thura. It is opening. It is opening. Shakaram Dineme. An increase in knowledge. An increase in knowledge. The septic wounds are healed in the name of Jesus. Oshalam Shekinabu. Hallelujah. So, the God is going to bless everyone, those who are watching. How many of you, if you have any problem in your ministry, in your family life, in your personal life, if you are facing many problems, many hurdles, but understand, if you are silent, if you do not murmur, God is going to bless you, God is going to anoint you. God is going to take you to the next level. Everyone, those who are watching this live video, the Lord is saying that if you accept your cross for the sake of Jesus, for the sake of me, Jesus is saying, I am going to increase the knowledge. You are going to see visions clearly. You are going to prophesy. Oh, Shakarinderima. Hallelujah. So Lord bless everyone. Let the prophetic anointing be increased. Let the grace of the Lord be upon everyone. Let healings take place. Let deliverance occur right now. Let the wounds be healed in the name of Jesus. Let all the knee pain, joint pain be healed right now in the name of Jesus. Oh, Shakaram Tariba. The Lord is increasing the favor. The Lord is increasing the anointing. Oh, Shakaram Tariba. To everyone. If anyone is saying that I have not received any word, but if you carry the cross of Jesus, if you are carrying your own cross for the sake of Jesus, Holy Spirit is saying that it is the what you are carrying with the accepting that it is the power. It is the power that make you reach the promise, that make you reach the acceptance. So receive the power of the Lord. Receive the anointing of the Lord. Receive the power of the Lord. Receive the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Let the fire of God be released right now. Let the fire of Holy Spirit be released right now. Let everyone be filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. You are going to catch the revelations like a Bluetooth. Brother Richards, you are going to have the revelation like a Bluetooth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I prophesy in the name of Jesus. Oshala Mishikunuba. Hallelujah. John Hubert, brother, you are going to have the ministry in your own place. In your own place. God is giving you some place of your own to start the ministry. Shakirin Turas. It is so. The light is, it has been not lighted, but now the Lord's light is coming upon your life. And whatever there is darkness is going to light. Now receive. Now receive the light. Sister Remya Rai, the light is shining upon you and your family. That I see the candle that was not lighted is now lighting, because the Lord is lighting your family. The Lord's anointing is upon you, and you are going to enter the new realm. Hallelujah. Lord is protecting you from all the COVID-19, you and your family. Shika Ram Tureme. Hallelujah. Lord bless everyone in the name of Jesus. So, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Lord bless everyone in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for the clarity. Thank you, Lord, for your presence released here. Thank you, Lord, for the revelation prophecy. Let everything come to happen in their life in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. So, I'm thankful to everyone. I'm thankful to everyone, those who are watching. So, God is going to bless everyone. Lisa Pius sister, I see the package of the Lord coming. Hallelujah. A breakthrough in your life. It is coming in your name. Lisa Pius sister, what you are desiring in your heart, it is coming in your name. Hallelujah. What you are desiring in your heart, it is coming in your name. Lisa Pius sister, hallelujah. Hallelujah. You won't lose anything. You will have the collateral security. Hallelujah. That, what is that collateral security? That is the grace of the Lord. So Mona Tumold sister, you have the collateral security. That is the grace of the Lord. So you won't lose anything. I see the knowledge is increasing, sister Mona Tumold. Lusha Rama Shekinebe. Hallelujah. God is blessing everyone in this group. So you are carrying the cross. You are carrying your own cross for the sake of Jesus. So, you do not murmur. So, God is going to bless you. God is going to raise you to the next level. If I have not mentioned your name, I prophesy to everyone, those who have not received any word from me, and even if anyone have received any word, but the Lord is saying that whatever problems you face through, be silent and accept it for the sake of Jesus, because you are carrying your own cross for the sake of Jesus. And whatever said in the Bible, the blessings are coming to you. You will become a head and not a tail. You will not borrow, but you will let. You will have a financial stability from this time onwards. Something is happening in your digital area, in your bank account. Something is happening. I see that the angels are coming and doing something. How many of you believe? How many of you say amen? Hallelujah. So, this is what I am not... when the time comes, the Lord will make it move what is stagnant. How many of you have that experience? For many, many months, for many years, something was not moving, it was stagnant. But when the time of the Lord comes, it will start moving. How many of you have that experience? So, I was using that digital app, the Google Pay, for many months it was not working. It was every time when I open it, it says the PIN is not correct, the password is not correct, but everything is correct. But when I open my app, it is saying it is not correct. But yesterday night, about 2 a.m. after my praying, and I was opening that app, it began to operate. I did not do anything. But after my prayer, and when I began to open, it began to operate, because it was not working for a long time. But when the time of the Lord came, it began to work. How many of you have experienced? So I am saying this as a testimony, because maybe you have been crying to the Lord for a long time. You are carrying the cross. You are carrying the cross, your own cross, for the sake of Jesus. And you are not seeing any blessing. But you are very near. You are very near. From my wisdom, I am saying. From what God has told me, I am saying. After this lockdown, from my experience, from my experience, and from the wisdom what God has given to me, I am telling you, whatever that has been stagnant, not moving, not working, you are carrying the cross and you are bearing it for the sake of Jesus, but no blessing. But do not murmur, but from my wisdom, from my knowledge which God has given me, I prophesy to you in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, carrying this Bible, and I prophesy to you, carrying this Bible, that from the knowledge which God has given to you, if you do not murmur, it is going to happen after this lockdown. After this lockdown, you are raised to the next level. Praise the Lord. Carrying this Bible, I prophesy in the name of Jesus, what the Lord has given me by wisdom, by knowledge, what the God Jehovah has told me by knowledge, by wisdom, I prophesy to everyone in the name of Jesus that after this lockdown, your lifestyle is going to change. Hallelujah. Your ministry is going to change. Your family setup is going to change. Hallelujah. Because you have been carrying the cross for a long time. Your financial situation is going to change. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are going to be seated in the royal seat. Hallelujah. How many of you believe? You are going to move to the nations. Hallelujah. So prepare yourselves in this time. Hallelujah. God has a plan for you. Hallelujah. So maybe you have been praying for many hours, but now when the door opens, you don't have time to pray, because you prayed a lot. You may have little time, but you are working for the Lord. So God is going to activate that in your life. So may God bless you in the name of Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for the clarity and everything and bringing everyone, your beloved children. I am humbled, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Amen. So I am thankful to all brothers and sisters. So your life is going to change because you carry the cross for the sake of Jesus. God is faithful. It is said, 1 Corinthians 1:18 says, it is the power of cross. It is the power of God. So you have the power of God. That power will deliver you. That power will honor you. That power will lift you because you have the anointing. Hallelujah. Because you have carried the cross, you have the anointing. So do not doubt. You are going to rise into the next level. So I'll be coming on live in this page next 2 weeks, same time. God bless everyone. Jesus' name. Amen.